नारायणाय परिपूर्ण गुणार्णवाय विश्वोदय सिद्धिलयो नियतिप्रदाय ज्ञानप्रदाय विबुधासुर सुख दुःख सत्कारणाय विदधाय नमो नमस्ते। यो विप्रलंब विपरीतमति प्रपूतान् बाधान् निरसकृतवान् पदुत्पवादं सर्वश सर्वेश्वरो हरिति प्रतिपादकं तम् आनंदतीर्थ मुनिवर्यम् अहं नमामि। पूज्याय राघवेन्द्राय सत्यधर्मरताय च भजतां कल्पवृक्षाय नमतां कामधेनवे श्रीकृष्णाय नमः। Now, why should one study the Lord's song? That is the Lord's song in the sense Bhagavad Gita. The Lord's song basically deals with the essence of life and living sensibly in the world. It analyzes the miseries of human life as traceable to the faulty understanding of the concept of Dharma and hence involvement in evil actions which usher in sorrow. Now people generally ask me, why should I study Bhagavad Gita? Now people think that Bhagavad Gita is only for those persons who are above 60 years or 70 years. So why should I study now? I am only 13 years, I am only 15 years, I am only 40 years, why should I study? I have so many things to do in my life. So that is what people think. I counteract by telling them that if you purchase a new car and if you do not know how to use that car and if you still drive that car without knowing how to drive, you will be hitting so many people on the road and you will be damaging the whole car. And finally, after so much of damage done to the car, if you think that I have to learn the driving properly and without knowing that I have done all these things, don't you think it is a farce, or don't you think it is a shame? So what is the use of studying Bhagavad Gita after a person has lived his life? We have to learn Bhagavad Gita before you lead the life, before you start leading the life. With the Dharma points which has been told by Bhagavad Gita author, that is Sri Krishna, if I am going to lead the life properly, or even if I am trying to lead the life properly, then I will be successful. That is the very reason why we should feel or why we should study Bhagavad Gita beforehand. So it analyzes the miseries of a human life. All of us know that human life is miserable. Everybody understands this and everybody should have experienced it. Even a person of 15 years old should have experienced the miseries of the life. So we should know why the miseries come. Now we don't want the miseries and we don't invite the miseries and we don't pray the Lord to give us only miseries, but the miseries come unsought. Why is this happening? We should know that. If we know why is this happening, then we will not we will be careful in our activities. Now who is the author of Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavan Vedavyasa is its author. Now who is Bhagavan Vedavyasa? Bhagavan Vedavyasa is Lord Sri Vishnu himself. He took this manifestation to educate humanity in the correct concept of Dharma so that it may observe the same during its life in the world and work for the liberation from cycle of births and deaths. So Bhagavad Gita has been given to the humanity or the mankind by Vedavyasa. Now everybody knows that Vedavyasa is a rishi. So that is one manifestation of the Lord. So it is only Bhagavan Vedavyasa. Vedavyasa and Narayana and Krishna or Narasimha or Rama, they are all one and the same. There is no difference. So that is the Bhagavan Vedavyasa's manifestation is a Jnanapurvaka. The manifestation, the reason for the manifestation of Vedavyasa is to educate the mankind about the Dharma. Now, if we know what is dharma and adharma, then we can practice that and we can cut the cycle of births and deaths. The more karma we do, there is more birth and there is more death. So, in that lifestyle, we undergo more miseries. So, we have to know the dharma. How did he know as to what happened in the battlefield? That is Kurukshetra. Since he is none other than Vishnu himself, he narrates what he is in the form of Krishna told to Arjuna in the battlefield. As I told you before, Vishnu is no different from Krishna or Vedavyasa. So, Vedavyasa knew perfectly what was happening in the battlefield as Krishna was there. So, he was easily able to narrate what happened in the battlefield. Now, is it ever possible to give a discourse so long in the battlefield? And this has been asked by many persons to me, and this is a very normal question, because there are tens of thousands of people are waiting in the battlefield, and the war is going to begin. So, two persons are going to stop the war and keep chatting in the battlefield. Is it possible? Do you think the whole tens of thousands of people will wait for the two persons to finish the discourse or finish the chat? It is not possible. But it has been possible in the case of Bhagavad Gita. Why? We should understand that the discourse giver is Lord Sri Krishna, who is referred to as Rishikesha. He controls the activities of all at all times, and it is not inconceivable that he could give the discourse as long as he desires. Humanity cannot act without his discretion. Rishikesha means controller of everybody's senses. He is controlling your sense and my sense as well. So, he was able to control the tens of thousands of people who were in the battlefield. He is a supreme being. Rishikesha means Sri Krishna. Means he is Vishnu. Means he is Rama. He is means Adokshaja. So, he was able to control everybody's senses without difficulty. Now, if so, why did he not prevent the battle? That is one more beautiful question people ask. Why did Krishna not control Duryodhana? Now we have the answer here. The Lord has given every opportunity to Duryodhana to live in peace with Pandavas. But the greed of Duryodhana would not allow him to even to part with the needle point of space for the Pandavas, and hence the option of war to contain evil was taken. Now, since Krishna as Rishikesha was able to control everybody's sense, why did he not control Duryodhana's sense? Now, we should know that there is an amount of independence which the Lord gives. We are dependent on the Lord. The Lord is independent always. We are always dependent. We cannot do anything on our own. We are always dependent. But the Lord is giving a small amount of independence so that we use the buddhi. This is called as buddhi yoga or jnana yoga, which the Lord discourses in the battlefield. That is jnana yoga. So, the Lord has given a complete discourse, or he has given every opportunity for Duryodhana not to wage war. But Duryodhana was hell bent on creating a hostile atmosphere. So, the Lord has to allow that to happen so that Duryodhana is killed ultimately. Sri Krishna Namaha. This is These are the questions which I picked, or the questions which I picked from my Guru's Bhagavad Gita book, 1008 questions answered, my Guru Shri Raghupati Rao. I am dedicating this video clip to my Guru's feet. Sri Krishna Namastu.